Good morning, YouTube family. How are you this morning? How are you today? And before we get started, I just want to say welcome, new subscribers. I really appreciate the fact that I am getting a few subscribers now. That's such a blessing. I'm excited about it and looking forward to actually growing my channel. And all of you who hang out and comment and give me tips and suggestions and all of that, I really think you're the ones, you know, getting me blessed like this, because it's from listening to you that people are interested in my content enough to subscribe. And I'm really excited about that. So I just wanted to say thank you to my OGs and my new Gs. All right, so now I want to get into talking about what I am talking about today. January came, February came, there were a ton of Valentine's releases, and in my humble opinion, just me, they all flopped. They came out, big promotion, big bang, and very few people were interested in purchasing them. Of course, the companies are continuing to bring out more and more and more stuff. And I thought the releases were good. I didn't buy them either, but that's because I just bought so much stuff just recently for Christmas and all the after Christmas sales, January, February. My mind is not on purchasing $40 and $50 and $100 items right now. So I just want to discuss with you why I think that the new releases that came out in January and February, and particularly the Valentine's Day releases, why I think that they were not received as well as they could have been at a different point in time. First of all, Too Faced released the White Peach palette. Some people can say, well, you know, it was just too light for most people. What are we going to do with that kind of thing? But there are a lot of light people who could use a very light white peach palette. I swatched it. I did a swatch video on my channel. You guys didn't even watch it. It is a highly pigmented palette. The swatches are good. I didn't purchase it myself, but I was interested, and I may pick it up in the future, you know, when I get through a few other things. It would fill some gaps in my collection and the stuff that I use like right now. But here's the thing, even though the White Peach palette came out, big old release, high quality palette, good shadows, nobody was even there for it. Now, here's my point. Right after the White Peach palette, to no avail, released, a lot of other palettes released with peach tones in them, copying the peach palette. To me, everybody else who's coming out with a peach palette, they don't call it a peach palette. It may not have the smell of a peach palette, but it has peachy colors in it, and it has colors that go good with peach. They released during the holiday season too. They had darker colors than the White Peach palette. The original peach palette did very well. Those palettes are still desirable to a lot of people. I hear a lot of people talking about the peach palette. A lot of people have the peach palette. A lot of people have the peach matte palette. But the white peach palette, people were not having the white peach palette. No, they were just not here for the white peach palette. Then recently, Vizart released a palette that had some beautiful peach tones in it. It had, the only two mattes in it were both peachy mattes. There was a light peachy matte and then a medium tone peachy matte color. Both these colors would look good on very light skinned people. Could use that medium peachy matte as a transition color, but I didn't see any color in there that would really be useful even for light people as a deep color. It had a lot of shimmery colors. People didn't seem to say that those shimmers had They didn't think the shimmers were the highest of quality shimmer. Bottom line, the few people who purchased that palette, their reviews were kind of shaky. And the majority of people are like, well, you know, even in their reviews, they're like, well, I can't use this to create a whole look. If I spend $50 on a palette, I mean, I can't even get one whole look out of it. And even though the reviews were saying they liked it, nobody claimed the shimmers of the people that I saw. Nobody claimed the shimmers were spectacular. They said the mattes were nice, but even some light people said they weren't deep enough for them to be a transition. But no problem. Vizart has a new palette releasing on the 23rd, right after that one. And this one has deep tones in it. So if you were to pick both of them up, you would have a complete peachy palette. And the new one coming out is a petite palette, and it has a orange, rich, deep tone color that looks good on as a transition color on a lot of people. It has dark browns, rich burgundies, all these kind of colors, but it's a petite pro palette. And you know, now the buzz is, I don't know if I should just buy this or not, because I'm not sure because of the Trist palette, if I'm gonna go for this one or not, like that. But it was swatched by Stephanie Nicole and Ripley, and it looked good on both of their skins. And I consider Stephanie Nicole to be very, very light, and I consider Ripley to be about my skin tone. I don't know, you know, I can't say for sure, but she's a brown skin woman, and it swatched beautifully on both of them. We are all kind of downsizing the gurus that we're willing to look at and say, okay, I trust that review. We're looking for people who maybe don't have the best camera quality, maybe their hair and their makeup isn't perfect, but we know how to work. We know how to look at what they're doing and see if it's real or not. Whereas people who are professional, have the best cameras, best lighting and stuff, everything looks good. Everything looks good. And we get home with our own bad lighting and our own, you know, whatever condition our skin is in, and we can't replicate those results. So that's what we're waiting for. We're waiting for the so-called real people reviews before we jump in there. Trist didn't pass the real people test. When the real people got it with the bad lighting and the wrinkles and the bags, they're, even the lightest people were like, I can't make this work for a full look. I gotta use another palette for the full look and then use this as kind of a topper palette. It's not a glitter palette, so I don't really see it as useful for that. But in my opinion, just based upon the looks that people have been able to get, the White Peach is a superior palette. Now, I'm gonna get into something else. Anastasia Beverly Hills is coming out with a palette that, to my eye, looks like a peach palette. So for the spring, she is releasing a peach palette. And I'm interested to know, is anybody interested in this peach palette? Looking at all the peach palettes, but with Anastasia Beverly Hills, I know that sometimes she makes her palettes in China. I know sometimes she uses talc in her palettes and sometimes she doesn't. Sometimes they're mica-based palettes and all that. So with her, I need to wait until her palettes are released, they're in the store, and I can see where it's made and what it's made of. But wait, if you think that's the only peach palette on the market, Marc Jacobs has a peach palette coming out as a spring release. I personally, am I the only one that's looking, am I the only one who has never bought a peach palette? You know, I don't own a peach palette because I got my Urban Decay Alistair Looking Glass. It had two or three duochrome peaches and it had a very, very light peach color that I loved. I used it all over my eye up until it was gone. It was so warm and buttery and nice. I really miss it. So I want those light colors back in my life. After I finish this palette, I'd like to add that back in. So I'm looking at these peach palettes for the future, trying to pick one out. I know I like Marc Jacobs' formula. If you saw my last Get Ready With Me video, I used my Marc Jacobs palette, which I've been seeing on the Sephora clearance for $49. It was a holiday, it was a gold box, and it was a holiday release like over a year ago. I just now started using it because it's all rose tones, which is a trend for this year coming up. Roses and pinks are gonna be on trend this year, but I already got mine, so I'm good with that. But I'm looking at these peachy pinks in their own freshness, because that just seems like something that will be beautiful for spring too. Anyway, Marc Jacobs is coming out with one. Now, I have noticed that Marc Jacobs palettes are expensive to the point where they can come out, people want them, the diehard Marc Jacobs fans will buy them, but Marc Jacobs does put his items on sale. He does mystery grab bags, all that kind of stuff, so you can catch his palette. So I'm looking at the Marc Jacobs palette, and I'm going, another peach palette. Are all of these peach palettes going to flop? I'll tell you palettes that we can talk about in another video, but every pastel palette that came out, even though people now do reviews who purchase pastel palettes, they all love their pastel palettes, every pastel palette that came out flopped. So our peach palettes, particularly light peach palettes that have light colors in them, are they the new palette that every company's going to release thinking it's going to be hot for spring and nobody's going for it? Is that what we can expect now? Do you like any of these palettes that have been released? Are you thinking about picking up a white peach or picking up the Visart Trist or their new one? And I believe more companies are gonna release peach palettes. Actually, come to think of it, Urban Decay is releasing a light pink rose palette that comes with blush and eyeshadow. And it is beautiful. I think that one's going to be a hot summer item. But if you want to know what I think are going to be hot spring and summer items that I think everybody's going to want, I'll do another video about the items that I think are going to be hot spring and summer items that you should consider. That's the only one I think, but it's more pink and rosy, so I don't know if that falls in that fresh spring light color or not. Let me know. I'm showing you the palettes here, telling you my opinions. I'm going to be a late purchaser. By the time I purchase it, because I have my palettes for this year, by the time I purchase it, hopefully they will be on sale. So I'm looking at it. I'm formulating my ideas. Got to get out of debt, use what I have for now, but I'm looking into these things for a future purchase. Are you thinking that you'll pick one of these up later? Or, you know, what are you thinking about this? You know, or are you thinking, no, I'm just over peach. I don't know why everybody's dropping peach in the summertime. Are you just sick of the whole spring fresh peach thing? I think it's a breath of fresh air. I'm so glad that companies are releasing season appropriate palettes. I wish they'd done that last year, but that's my opinion on this matter, and thanks for watching this video. Hey, do you remember? Jesus loves you, and I love you with all the Jesus in me, and right now I'm really thinking, I hope I haven't done this whole video with red lipstick on my teeth, because when you wear red lipstick sometimes, and your teeth are as big as mine, sometimes, you know, you run into a few issues. Well, in any event, if I did do it and I don't catch it, sorry about that. And please subscribe if you're not already subscribed and watch another one of my videos. Thank you. Appreciate you.